Hello everybody and welcome to Squareballoon Actions and Tutorials. This tutorial is for Photoshop CS. I'm using 6 but it'll work on any previous versions as well. And I'm going to change the background here so we just have a smooth color rather than this texture blanket that I had. And I'm also going to extend the planks a little bit to add a little bit more of an infinity look to those planks there. We'll do a little bit of work in RAW and editing the skin also. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to open this image in Adobe Camera Raw. So this is the raw version. It's a little bit underexposed. The white balance was on auto white balance. So we'll just have a little look at that too. We'll do what we need to do in RAW first. So I'm going to bring up the exposure. I've got my clipping warnings on here to make sure that I'm not blowing my highlights. And it's dark from this angle here because all the natural light was coming in from the left hand side. So I'm going to use a gradient to bring a little bit of light in from this side too. So raise the exposure. Once the gradient is drawn, you can use the sliders to raise the exposure. So that's fine. It's a little bit darker up here in the corner. So I don't need so much exposure as I had on the other side. So yeah, that looks fine. Let me just have a look at the temperature. Let me bring the temperature up a little bit overall. Okay, so we'll open that up in Photoshop now. Let me just close these other ones. So looking at it there, one thing I want to do is I want to change the crop slightly. So I'll start off by doing that. I've got my crop tool on. I'm just going to turn it so that my horizon is a little bit straighter. Because I'm cropping beyond what I took, I will have to do a little bit of cloning, but that's all right. Let's just get that box straight. Okay, so there's our new crop. I'm going to use my clone tool first. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to bring the planks down here where we deleted some areas, and then I'm going to also bring these planks up a little bit behind the box to give a more look of infinity. So I always clone on a new layer, on a separate layer. So I've got my clone tool with the opacity of 100% and my sample is set to current and below. That means that I can clone onto this blank layer here but sample from the layer below it. So I hold down Alt to get my sample and then I can just line it up like that. And when you're working with perspective, you're going to have to keep sampling, otherwise the perspective won't work out. So once you've got the planks done, then you can fill in the in-between bits as well. And then over here at the edge, it would be all right if this is just white to the edge. Okay, so now we're going to go up a little bit too. And again, just keep holding down Alt, or keep sampling by holding Alt every now and then, just to keep your samples to matching up with what's there. And I might use this one over here just to give the impression of another plank over here. And then we'll do the same on the other side. So this flooring that I used here, it is just planks of wood, tongue and groove, they just click together. So they separate out when I'm not using them. But I've also found that paneling works very well. Now I have three sheets of paneling that I clip together. Okay, so the colour is a little uneven there, but we really just want to give the impression that the planks are going a little bit further back. So we can tidy that up afterwards. Okay, so once I've done that, I'm going to flatten that down, and now I'm going to make my gradient. So I want the gradient to match up with the colours that are in the floor here. So I'm going to take, click on the gradient tool. I make sure that it's on radial. So for my foreground colour, I choose a pale colour from beside the baby. I'm going to make a little bit paler than that. And then for the background colour, I'm going to choose a colour that's already in the planks. So we'll choose a colour like, maybe somewhere around there. Make a new layer, make my gradient, so click in the center, all the way out to the edge. So there's my gradient. I'll take that off just for a second so I can click on the background layer here so I can start masking. I use my quick selection tool, set to plus at the moment, make it a little bit smaller, and just going to select around the bits that I don't want the gradient to go over. If you hold down Alt, you'll get the minus tool. It'll deselect areas. So once I've selected everywhere that I don't want the gradient to be on, I can go to Refine Edge, and then I can see what the edges are going to be like. I can see that I'm going to have to do a little bit of work around here, but I have my output set to selection. I'm making sure that I have Smart Radius on because that does a good job of selecting around here. I click OK. And once that Refine Edge is there, I can click back onto my gradient and hold down Alt as I click the Mask tool, and that'll automatically mask back. So obviously I want to bring my planks down here in the foreground back in again. I clicked on the mask here, and with a paintbrush set to black, because that'll mask back this gradient here, I'm going to bring those planks back in. Okay, so once they're in, I'm going to then change the opacity of my brush down. I'm going to bring it down a little bit so that we get a better fade. And then even down a little bit more just to see what I can still bring in. Okay, so that looks pretty good. They're going back as far as I had cloned them back. And now what I want to do is I want to make sure that this gradient here blends a little bit better with the floor. So here it's a little bit darker than the background here, but I can paint onto this gradient here, but it'll be masked back still. The mask will still stay. So I'm going to take my paintbrush and leave the opacity at about 50%, and I'll bring back in some of the colour that's in the floor there. Bring it up another little bit. And then this would be the darker side. So I can bring some of the darker colour back in there. And we can go back in where we said earlier on that it would need a little bit more work on masking back that. I can just make a white paintbrush at 100% opacity and just go back in and tidy up those bits that the Refine Edge didn't do perfectly. So I can go back in. So the edges aren't too bad, there's just a few areas that it didn't do perfectly, so we'll just go back in and tidy those areas up. Maybe bring a little bit of this back in. So I can see down at the bottom corner here where I was cloning, it left a little paler patch there. So I can use my burn tool down there if I want, just to bring that even up that colour down there. And you can use the burn and the dodge tool for all those kind of things if you just want to bring a little bit of lightness or darkness to a certain area. You can use your burn tool or your dodge tool. So once we've done that and we're happy with the way the background is fading off there like that, let me just work another tiny bit with that. Once we're happy with that, then we can start editing the picture as a whole then. Let's even up that a little bit. I see another little bit here that I need to get rid of. So I'm going to flatten that down, and I'm just going to look at the picture as a whole now. And what I'd like to do is I'd like to work on the skin a little bit. So I'm going to go in and just go close up on the skin for a moment. I'll do my usual skin editing techniques, which is just to use the spot healing tool just to get rid of those little bits. I'm going to use my lighten up action just to bring a little bit more, put on paintbrush. To use the lighten up action just to bring a little bit more light to some of the darker areas here. Then I'm going to use my skin smoothing action. I'm going to bring the opacity of this down. I don't want it to be too smooth. And I'm also going to use EyeDefine, which will bring a little bit of contrast to eyelashes and lips, the bottom of the nose there, and maybe the hair, and maybe even a little bit of red skin removal just on the eyelash. So when I look at that, the skin looks pretty good, but I'm just going to do I'm going to do a little paint on warmth as well, just to warm up that skin a little bit. And I'm doing it at 100% here, but then I'm going to use the just slide the opacity down afterwards. So let's go back out here and see how that looks. So I'm pretty happy with that. You know, you can be a bit neater, even up the colors a little bit more, but it's just a way to show you how to change a background if you weren't happy with your initial setup, that you can just mask back. And also if you're shooting in a small area, you can also, using cloning, extend things out a little bit to give it a little bit more of a feeling of space around your subject.